Hey there, welcome back to TickTick's channel. Have you ever found yourself feeling more confused the more you try to organize your tasks? Or the longer your to-do list grows, the more anxious you feel? Maybe what you're missing isn't willpower. It's a clear, reliable system that frees your mind. Today, we'll start from the ground up and explore the method that's often called the Bible of Productivity, GTD, short for Getting Things Done. Once you understand the method, we'll see how to put it into practice inside TickTick, so you can finally say goodbye to task anxiety. GTD stands for Getting Things Done, a methodology that helps you capture everything on your mind into an external system and organize it properly. The main goal? To clear your mind, so you always know what to do next, without the mental clutter. The GTD process can be broken down into 5 stages. Step 1. Capture. Write everything down. Move all ideas, reminders, and to-dos from your head into a trusted system. Step 2. Clarify. Before organizing, ask yourself, is it actionable? Can it be done in one step? Will it take less than 2 minutes? Step 3. Organize. Sort items based on your answers. Usually, tasks fall into these 4 categories. Projects. Tasks that need to be broken down into smaller parts. For example, an OKR goal often contains multiple subtasks. Actions. Concrete, executable tasks with clear outcomes or time limits. Waiting for. Tasks that depend on someone else or an external condition before you can proceed. Someday, maybe. Ideas are tasks you're not yet sure about pursuing. Step 4. Reflect. Review your lists regularly. Decide the next actions and assign time for them. Step 5. Engage. Focus on doing one thing at a time. TickTick's workflow is simple. Create tasks when needed, complete them when done. Its structure is clear and layered. At the top, you have folders. Inside each folder are lists, and within lists are tasks. Each task can have subtasks, and tasks can reference each other, allowing flexible organization. Let's start with the first GTD step, capture. In TickTick, this means creating a new task, the starting point of all task management. GTD emphasizes immediate capture. Whenever something comes to mind, jot it down. At this stage, don't worry about categories, due dates, or priorities. Just add everything to your inbox and sort it later during your review time. Of course, if you already know where a task belongs, you can assign it right away. Here's the golden rule: capture at any time. As soon as a new thought or task appears, record it immediately. Don't rely on memory. It drains mental energy and increases the risk of forgetting something important. A couple of extra tips for creating tasks. For recurring routines like weekly meeting or payday, set them as repeating tasks. No need to create them manually each time. When adding a task, always add details. This helps you remember the context later, such as who you need to contact, reference emails, or related documents. As your list grows, the next key challenge is how to manage tasks efficiently. Unlike capturing, managing tasks doesn't have to be done in real time. You can schedule short review sessions. For example, when taking a coffee break or right after finishing a task, to clean up your inbox and sort new tasks. Visually, you can create different folders and lists for areas like work, personal, and life, and assign colors to distinguish them. On the GTD side, you can use tags to label tasks as project, action, waiting, or maybe. In practice, most tasks fall into the action category, so you can simplify by treating unlabeled tasks as action by default. Here's how you might label tasks. Add the project tag for tasks that need further breakdown. Leave it untagged if it's an action task ready to be done. Use the maybe tag for unclear or optional ideas. Use the waiting tag for tasks pending others' input. After tagging, move each task into the right list, for example, under work, personal, or life, to keep everything tidy.
For light users, lists are usually enough. But as tasks pile up, managing them by list alone becomes overwhelming. That's where TickTick's calendar view comes in. It helps you visualize when tasks happen and how your time is distributed. The calendar is divided into two parts. The top shows all day or unscheduled tasks. The bottom shows timed tasks, reflecting the sequence and duration of your focused work blocks. When you enable the combined task plus calendar view, the left panel shows structured tasks, while the right panel displays your calendar. You can drag tasks between the two, from list to calendar to assign time, or from calendar to list for organization. In TickTick, time blocks on the calendar are shown as rectangles, with 15 minutes as the smallest unit, representing how long a task takes. A few time management tips. Block out non-flexible time first, like meetings, lunch breaks, or weekly reviews. When you've pre-scheduled these blocks, TickTick will remind you at the right time. Since tasks retain their context, description, attachments, and related info, you can easily recall what you need to do when the reminder appears. After completing a task, click Complete. Before starting the next one, take a short break, tidy your inbox, or adjust your calendar blocks if needed. Of course, real life is messy. Plans change. Sometimes a task takes longer than expected, or something urgent pops up. When that happens, just move your time blocks accordingly. It may seem tedious, but actively managing time blocks helps you stay aware of what's next, instead of reacting to chaos. It also reminds you not to overpack your schedule. Always leave buffer time for changes. If something doesn't get done, don't beat yourself up. Simply reschedule it for another day. And that's the complete walkthrough of GTD and how to apply it in TickTick. I hope this system helps you, just like it helped me, to end productivity burnout and regain a sense of calm control over your work and life.